$5 a barrel for them to even break even. They're losing money big time right now. That's why we've been seeing
Mr. Johnson
a huge uptick in activity when it comes to what's going on over
Ron
there.
Tankers
being kidnapped, drone attacks, and the like. Of course, this footage is mesmerizing, and they're going to use it to justify the run on oil, which will translate to higher gas prices in the future. Enjoy it now, ladies and gentlemen, because the cash cow is coming home. Moo, cows. How many people thought Gladio B as soon as they saw the news? Of course, you know, this is just part of what's going on. A very convenient attack, not only for big oil, but for this administration and previous administrations who were, well, let's just say, caught with their pants down with this Epstein case. Of course, the Epstein murder is still a huge enigma. You know, first they let Jussie Smollett go, and it seems now they let Epstein go as well. But this is just perfect timing and more bread and circus as people are worried about the world's oil supply. We're certainly not talking about the eugenics programs out there, the 5G death towers that are coming to a neighborhood near you. We're certainly not talking about them spraying you like bugs with the pesticides, with the chemicals that they spray for mosquitoes. You are the mosquito out there. And while these oil fields are burning, we're not talking about the fluoride in the water, the poisons in the vaccines. We're certainly not talking about the brain damage caused in public schools these days with the indoctrination. We're not rounding up the criminals. We didn't round up anybody after the American coup d'etat led by the FBI and other rogue elements of the deep state. You know, when there was a coup d'etat in Turkey, they rounded up tens of thousands of people. Mass incarceration, mass imprisonment, ladies and gentlemen. And here they've done nothing. They're just like, do it again. Because as long as people are talking about, you know, skull and bones versus skull and bones, Democrat versus Republican, they're not talking about the big picture. As long as you're picking a side, Trump or the Democrats, then you're really defending the system. Of course you like what they have to say on television. That's the point of it. It's product placement for the dark side. And as long as you're choosing, you know, somebody you see on television, the entire country is losing. And of course, when we talk about events like this, the entire country, the entire world is losing. They're going to say that the loss of oil in the Middle East here is going to be justification for a huge adjustment in the price. But, you know, right now the market is so overloaded with cheap oil from fracking and the like that there is no justification for it. We're producing more oil than they are, and yet the prices haven't really reflected that change. But don't worry, our industries will be loving this Gladio B event, and that's the point. And while, you know, we should be celebrating, you know, jobs and the economy, you know, selling your soul just isn't worth it. And, you know, when they're trashing the planet, poisoning everything that moves, spraying you like bugs, it doesn't matter if you have a job. You're in a concentration camp and you're getting gassed by the deep state. You know, pick your deep state, pick your poison. It's history repeating itself over and over and over again. And, you know, our aim with these broadcasts is to remind people that behind the veil of the bread and circus, behind the veil of these shows, there's a wizard pulling the levers out there. They're manipulating you. And it should be obvious as can be. Most people get that. But for some reason, we continue to pretend like nothing has changed. People's understanding has changed. And that's why they're censoring everyone. They don't want people to talk about it anymore. They're hoping that you'll forget everything you've learned since 9/11. and it's rather unbelievable, to say the least. You know, the depth at which these people will go to get their way. They'll send in vigilantes into the schools and murder children, and then they'll come on television demanding that you disarm yourselves. You know, they'll kill more people than diseases will with their vaccines, but, you know, they'll make it mandatory. In every case, these people cause more harm than good, and by playing along with, you know, the narrative, we're just inciting more mass murder by these deep state Luciferian operatives out there, and have no doubt that these people are of the dark side. If you turn on the television, it's product placement for the seven deadly sins. It's product placement for anti-Christian ideology. It's product placement for Sodom and Gomorrah and the Santa Claus, the Satan Claus, if you will, ladies and gentlemen. And nothing is more diabolical than fossil fuels, a liquid graveyard. Liquid death being pumped from the ground, and they make everything with it. Brought to you by this cult of death, these Charlie Manson groupies. Skull and bones, ladies and gentlemen. The death head, that's what these people are. And everything they put out there, everything they promote, is death. That is the nature of their fruits. They are the evil tree. Never forget that. And while talking about it is important, doing something about it is even more important. Everyone can begin a silent protest against death towers, against vaccines, against fluoride in their town. Anything that strikes back against the eugenics program, against this cult of death, is a step in the right direction. Everybody should be talking about the Bible out there. Everybody should be controlling the narrative, and manifesting your intent in the real world is more powerful than in cyberspace. In cyberspace, nobody sees it anymore thanks to the censorship. But even if you're by yourself holding up a little sign near the shopping mall or at an intersection, you're causing more real change than in cyberspace. You know, the days of putting out mega videos, hitting back at the dark side, are pretty much over. We need to bring this to the real world with civil disobedience. And they want you to obey, you must disobey. They want you to take the vaccines, you must not take the vaccines. They want you to eat the GMOs, you must not eat the GMOs. They want you to drink the tap water, don't drink the tap water. They want you to give up your guns, don't do that either. They want you to remain silent, fuck them. Ladies and gentlemen, don't go out quietly into the night. Don't go out without a fight. That's the least we should be saying here. If you're just joining us, major Gladio B event rocks the Middle East. Oil prices are set to surge. Gas prices are going to skyrocket thanks to this attack. What convenient timing. The oil industry was losing big time with these record low oil prices, record low for the post 9/11 world. And of course, you know, they needed something. And the Gulf of Hormuz, Gulf of Tonkin 2.0, didn't seem to work for them. They tried again with other attacks, and now it's come to this. They're saying that basically drones flew cross country, right through the heart of their country, where there must be absolutely no air defenses, no radar, no way to pick these things up. And it just happened to sneak up on them from behind after traversing, you know, thousands of miles, or let's say 1,000 miles into their country. You'd think that they'd have, you know, something, you know, set up in case this might happen, some kind of contingency. You'd think somebody would have thought of this, but no, they're like, blow it up, please, please blow it up. Insurance will pay for it, and then the oil prices will go up. So, I mean, either they did this on purpose or, you know, they're willfully negligent. And you never can say for sure these days, but it certainly looks bad. Everybody's talking about this, and you'll be talking about it more next week as you see the action in the markets. And, you know, they're pumping this up, and this could be the big one, they're starting to say. And, you know, for what? For what, ladies and gentlemen? Fossil fuels, they seem to be everywhere. And they, you know, they like it that way. They like having this product that's as available as water and selling it to you at a ridiculous price, taxing it. You know, you think gas prices are high in America, you should see what they are in Europe. They're paying about seven times more. Perhaps, maybe five times more. But at least $7-$8 a gallon. Just depends where you live. But, you know, they're selling this stuff like it's cocaine, bitches. And everybody's addicted. Cars could be running on water. And, you know, they continue with this, with this engagement so that they can, you know, pump more death into the world. Everything that burns oil causes death. And everything they make with it pretty much has a nasty side effect, ladies and gentlemen. So it is what it is out there. We're going to have to leave it there for this broadcast. We appreciate everybody tuning in. Please like and share. Feel free to mirror this content. You know, thanks to the censorship, it's impossible to get the news out there. Free speech is banned. Words are banned. Ideas are banned. And you've probably already been listed as a thought criminal out there. It's too late to not be on the red list, so you might as well act like it. Ladies and gentlemen, civil disobedience, go out there, boycott, get people involved. Do not support this cult of death. Do not support the television. Do not support Skull and Bones. No matter, you know, if you like what they're selling you or not, because they're just going to use that against you. They're dangling it like bait. And they're like, oh, you want free healthcare? Oh, you want lower taxes? Vote for me, vote for me. Behind the scenes, they continue to trash the planet, promote endless wars, and poison the people out there. And everybody's being targeted. Everybody should forget about, you know, what they think they're angry about out there and, you know, wake up again. You were awake, you went back to sleep. You let the hate drive you there. Now come back out of it and, you know, get back to where you were before the 2016 election. You know, this Epstein case confirmed the pedo wood, confirmed the WikiLeaks. We're on the right track. We've got them by the balls, and they know it. Ladies and gentlemen, don't let them escape. Keep pushing the narrative out there. Until the next time, if you're listening to this, you are the resistance.
I know they're going to be shot. Two sets of blades in my office at the back there and a ratchet. Well, by the time they get here, they're going to be there, sure. But I need new blades on it. I like to put on it. I got a lot of crap here. Probably the last one.